Good morning, guys. Welcome to Schlag at number 22. It is a Saturday morning, and that means I am getting here late, which is awesome. I got some extra sleep. I got yesterday's Schlag edited. That's cool. And now it's time to get to work, which is awesome. We got to finish up the 300 today. Really just check, make sure carburetor is good. It was leaking a little bit out of the float bowl. I think that's just because it's been sitting for a while. We might need to put a new gasket on that. Put a good, clean, serviced air filter in it, and then take it for a ride. And if everything is good, which it should be, then we will call the customer and see if he is ready to pop some wheelies. So that's awesome. After that, we need to look at this DR650. Not much going on there. Just normal stuff. Service. Fix the speedo, although I think that just needs a battery because it's aftermarket and some other stuff. And then I think, move on to the next project. I gotta look and see exactly what that is. We got a couple 350s to do work to, and anyway, so right on. So join me for today. Saturdays I keep real informal and kind of relaxed because it's Saturday, right? It's a weekend, should be fun. So we might just sit down actually and talk a little bit about tires. In fact, I'm actually absolutely going to do that later on this schlag because I want to give you my opinion on tires. Everybody has an opinion on tires. So do I. I hope you guys enjoy it. It should be a lot of fun. Anyway, I'm going to open up the shop, push the bikes out. We'll see you guys in just a bit. I have been going crazy today. Customers coming in. I've been reorganizing, trying to make a nice little zone for my motorcycles over there and getting rid of some stuff. And anyway, finally getting to this thing. So let me show you what's kind of going on. Well, it's hard to see, but it's wet down under here. And it's wet right along that edge. So I think the float bowl gasket's just junk. This thing sat for quite a while after he blew it up. Just saving money up to get it fixed. So I have a float bowl gasket for that thing, so I'm going to take that off, get that done, put the air filter in it, get the chain on it, which it desperately needs, and then take it for a test drive, make sure everything's good. Yeah, that is the old original gasket. It's super brittle. It hasn't broken, which is pretty impressive, but I got one of those. That's going to fix it. We'll go grab that. Boom! There we go.
Yeah, real happy with the way that runs. Super stoked. It's gonna be a good bike. Well, it already has been a wonderful bike for him, and now it's gonna be a really awesome bike for a lot longer. Rebuild your stuff, folks. It's worth it. Obviously, there are some bikes out there that are not worth rebuilding. I'm not gonna lie. Anyway, but you know, a good 300, it's worth sinking a little bit of money into and making it rip again. So, super happy with that. Awesome. Dirt bikes. All right, guys. So I told you I would have a little talk with you about tires. It's actually going to be a lot shorter than what I bet you think I was going to do. Everybody's got opinions about tires. Every one of these YouTube channels has tons of opinion about tires. And I've done quite a few reviews and things like that on tires and mousses and all kinds of stuff, right? So what I really want to say is stop freaking worrying about it. I can tell the difference between a good tire and a bad tire, and I'm sure you can too. And hopefully maybe there's some super duper pro guys on here that know like every little bit of difference. But the reality is,
my opinion about a tire is going to be different than your opinion about a tire. For instance, this one right here, that's the Tusk Recon. It's a good tire. I like it. This one down here, it's the Kenda Parker DT. Great tire. I like that one too. Sedona, I don't really like it. I got customers that absolutely freaking love that tire. I got a Michelin thing here. I got a Pirelli. I got a Dunlop. You know what? Form your own opinion. Maybe watch, you know, please watch my videos on reviewing tires. I mean, that's great. Good information. But just buy a set of tires, go ride them, and make up your own mind. Because seriously, I've had tires that I absolutely love. For instance, I absolutely 100% like the Bridgestone M59 in the front and a Bridgestone X30 in the rear. That is my absolute favorite tire combination, period. I haven't found one that I like better. I'm going to keep looking, but I haven't found one that I like any better. So I absolutely love that tire. I have customers, good friends of mine, who I've ridden with, who are very good riders, who I would have thought would have loved it. They don't like it. They think it wears out too fast and this and that and what. So enough of the bickering and arguing over tires on the internet. It drives me crazy. Buy round ones, put them on your motorcycle, and go ride. I know that's maybe not the nicest way to put it, or the I'm not selling any tires today, but by saying that stuff. But I, you know, a good, sharp, new knobby is better than any worn-out one. That's for sure. And you know what? I've been passed by people on bald tires so many times. It's the person behind the throttle more than the actual thing. So I'm going to keep giving you my opinions on these things about how I ride, you know, and the way it works for me and all that. Absolutely, 100%. But I'm going to tell you right now, I suggest that if you think you want to try a Tusk Recon, just try it. Those are cheap, $65 through me or 50 something through Rocky Mountain. Try it. You know what? And if you don't like it, if it feels too slippery, that's okay. Learn how to ride on it. So the next time you put a super grippy tire on, you're going to be even better off, right? Maybe we should all put tubes in our tires, put 20 pounds in them, and go actually learn how to control our motorcycles, because I think it would make us all better riders. So that then, when you get the chance to put a really grippy, awesome set of tires on with just the right mousse or just the right tire pressure, then you got, you know, you got it under control and you can go even faster. So anyway, that's my short thing on tires. I just wanted to say that. You just got to make your own opinion at some point. I'm going to keep making videos about them. Tire manufacturers, please send me tires. I will test them and give you my honest opinion, 100%. But just know they're my opinion. I'm a guy who lives in Western Colorado, mainly rides in Western Colorado, who likes two strokes and who likes to spin the rear tire. So that's going to change my opinion of a tire versus a guy who likes four strokes, who lives back east, who likes to have more throttle control and more clutch control, versus a guy who lives in Southern California, who rides mainly motocross, who rides a 450 wide open all the time, versus a guy who rides trial speeds through the gnarliest of gnar in hard enduro stuff. So, you know, all those different guys are going to have differing opinions on different tires. So there we go. I hope that helps with your tire selection. But yeah, had a great day today, guys. It's been crazy. Sorry I didn't film too much. But let's go back and take a look at what we got coming up next week, because it's going to be a good week. All right, so we had a good day today. Lots of stuff getting dropped off, so pretty exciting. Going to be a fun week next week, so make sure you're subscribing to the channel and getting that notification bell clicked, because, yeah, we got good stuff coming up. So start with right here, 500 KTM EXC with all the BS pulled off of it, so it runs good. Doing tires, mousses, full suspension service, and checking valves, and oh, steering stabilizer, and I think that's it. The work order's in there. Anyway, lots of stuff on that. That's gonna be good. Tons of good videos coming out of that bike. Same gentleman brought me this beauty. It's 1974, I believe. Yep. 1974 Honda Trail 70. Really super straight, actually. Rusty because it's been hanging out, but man, this thing is clean. All the guards are in place. Everything's in place. All the parts are here. The seat looks good. So we're going to be going through that thing, getting it running because it doesn't yet, and kind of making a list for him on what we think we should do. It's going to be his pit bike to chase his kids around and just look really cool. So I'm really stoked about that. I mentioned it before, but we're going to be working on this DR650. I haven't actually moved forward on it yet, but that's coming soon. 2020 YZ450F. Just going to be dressing this one up with stickers and some other things. Nothing huge on that one. We just lowered the 2020 YZ250FX with a Duval link. So there she is. Dropped that down. We raised the forks up as much as we could without hitting the bars. So that thing is lowered. That is for a woman who is tiny. She's actually not, she's relatively short, but she's just minuscule little woman. So we lowered it. We might be going through the suspension later and really soften it up, but I wanted to ride it first and kind of get a feel of how that's going. And then we got a 450 XCFW dropped off, which was owned by a friend of ours. He sold it to another friend of ours. It's been a great bike, but now it's having some issues. It's overheating and building pressure in the cooling system and making a funny noise. So it may have some big problems. So that's gonna be a good one. That'll be like a what's inside. Find out what's going on with that. There's our 350 XCF that we're waiting on top end parts for. We got the piston in. Now we're just waiting on gaskets and things like that. We had to get those direct from KTM. They're on their way. And yeah, there's that thing still. whatever, I figured it out. Bad ball joints are gonna be, I'm not gonna show you that, but that's what I get to do. There's our 350 XCW that had the bad valves. So hopefully that'll all be in next week. We'll put that together. So we got a bunch of work to do next week, folks. And I'm excited about that. I like working on dirt bikes, it's awesome. Oh, and this would be a good thing to show you guys. So that is my YZ250. There's Daisy, obviously. This is my YZ250 named Jolene. I've got it in pieces because I'm sending the shock to Brady Metter at TBT Racing in Oklahoma, and he's going to get that all dressed up and ready to go to match my forks from TBT Racing, finally. So I'm excited about that. Also, I'm going to be taking this Lectron apart and cleaning it, and also hopefully getting it running better. That is the Lectron that I haven't loved on this bike, but I'm going to give it a shot, see if I can't tune it and make it better so that I do love it, and get the YZ ready. So I got two ripping 250s for this season, which is awesome, and I feel very lucky and blessed to have that. So yeah, I love my life, guys. I love sharing it with you. Thank you so much for watching all these videos. It really does mean a ton to me. And the channel's growing, and that just fills my heart. So thank you so much. And as always, I hope you get out, spread the gospel of two wheels, and most importantly, you got to find some time to ride dirt bikes!